Hi everyone, it's great to see you again. Now you might remember if you joined us last week that we looked at a psalm. We looked at Psalm 139, which told us that wherever we go and whatever we do, God is always with us and that there is nowhere that His love can't reach us. And this week we're going to be thinking about another psalm. This week we're looking at Psalm 23, which tells us about how God is like a shepherd, like the perfect shepherd who takes really good care of us and protects us from all danger. So let's read the psalm together now. The Lord is my shepherd. He gives me everything I need. He lets me lie down in fields of green grass. He leads me beside quiet waters. That's a lovely picture, isn't it? Of how God protects us and how He takes care of us. So now it's time to get creative. And what I would like you to do is you could have a think, you could write it down, draw a picture, or talk about it with your family or whoever you're watching this video with, and have a think about what caring and protecting looks like for you right now. So I'm going to pause the video now, I'm going to draw a picture, you have a think, and then we'll come back together in a minute and I'll show you what I've come up with. How did you get on? What does caring and protecting look like for you? I wonder whether some of you might have drawn maybe a superhero rescuing someone, or maybe you've drawn a mummy or daddy or other grown-up taking care of a tiny baby. Well, this is what I drew. I drew an ambulance and a hospital because I was thinking about how at the moment lots of doctors and nurses and paramedics and other carers are working really, really hard to protect us all from coronavirus. Now Nathan is going to read to us from this book, Wonder and Wisdom, and we'll hear more about Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd. Because God is so vast and wonderful and bigger than anything that we could fully imagine, we sometimes use pictures to understand who He is and what He's like. All through the Bible, God is described like a shepherd. Shepherds needed to be strong protectors, keeping wild animals away from their sheep. They also had to watch over the sheep and guide them, sometimes through dangerous places. The shepherd stayed with his sheep and they knew his voice. The safest place for the sheep was always by their shepherd's side. David was a powerful king and he had an army to lead and battles to fight. But when he thought about God, it wasn't just as a strong ruler. His God was also tender and gentle. He was loving. David knew that he was loved and cared for. He knew that he was watched over and known. And you know, the same is true for us. God is our shepherd, and no matter what life looks like, He is always there to watch over us and to guide us. He knows exactly what we need, and He cares for us. It's important for us to listen for His voice and to stay close to Him. So, always remember that God is like a shepherd who guides us, protects us, and cares for us.
Just like God cares for us and looks after us, There are lots of other people in our community right now who are working hard to care for us and protect us. So in a moment, I'm going to ask you to pause the video and have a think about three people who you would especially like to thank God for. You might think about your teachers who are working really hard to care for you, whether you're at school or whether you're at home. You might want to think about your parents. You might want to think about the people who are working in shops and farms and the delivery drivers, all working really hard to make sure that we have enough food to eat. There are all sorts of people working hard to care for us and protect us at the moment. So pause the video now and have a chat with the people you're watching the video with. Let's pray together now. Father God, we thank you that you are like a good shepherd who cares for his sheep. We thank you that you will always protect us, that you will keep us safe, and that you are always with us. And we know that the safest place for us to be is by your side. And we want to say thank you today for all of the other people that you've put in our lives to help care for us and protect us. We thank you for our teachers. We thank you for our parents and the other grown-ups taking care of us. We thank you for all the people who are working in hospitals and shops and other services, making sure that we have everything that we need. We thank you for all of the other people who we've talked about with our families at home as well. We pray that you will be with them and that you will keep them safe. Amen. Well, thank you for joining us again this week. It's been lovely to be with you, and we look forward to seeing you again next week.